to San Francisco, she must have lost her way. Posting a poster of Poncho and Cisco one California day. She says she believes in a Robin Hood and brotherhood and colors of green and gray. And all you can do is laugh at her. Doesn't anybody know how to pray? Arizona, take off your rainbow shades. Arizona, have another look at the world. Your pride, you're acting like a teeny bopper runaway child. And scrape off the paint from the face of a little town saint. Arizona, take off your hobo shoes. Arizona, hey, won't you go my way? I will be guide your way. I'll be the Count of Monte Cristo. You'll be the Countess May. You can believe in Robin Hood and Brotherhood and rolling the ball in the hay. And I will be reading you an Aesop's fable. Anything to make you stay. Arizona, take off your rainbow shades. Arizona, the world might lie. Arizona, cut off your Indian braids. Arizona, hey, won't you go my way? Hey, Arizona.
yourself is a kind of what you want. You're gonna make it happen, make it happen. And if you're on your knees at night and pray to the Lord, He's gonna make it happen, make it happen.
Hi, Cynd. So sorry I couldn't be there with you today. I'm sure you're having a great time. I'm so excited for you and Fred with this great new opportunity and new adventure for both of you. You both deserve it. I know someone in Arizona is going to be really lucky to have you, and they already are really lucky to have Fred. Blessings and prayers for the futures and your travels, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.
I will remember you.
Cyndi, I just want to wish you well on your trip to Arizona and tell you how much we appreciate all your hard work on the board of directors and all of your advocacy for children throughout the state of Florida. All your initiatives on prevention have been a model for others throughout the community, the state, to use, and we just appreciate all that hard work. I first had a chance to meet you in Tampa many, many years ago when you first came to Florida to work for the Department of Children and Families. And we were working with David Fairbanks on creating a readiness tool for determining when CBCs would be ready to take over in a community. And I think your work at that time and since that time has just been a great asset. You've helped many, many children and their families. Thank you, and we wish you well.
Will you?
Hi, Cyndi. This is Mary Armstrong at the University of South Florida, and I'm representing all the members of the USF team that have worked with you over the years. We want to wish you well, and we want to especially acknowledge your openness to innovation in trying to improve services for at-risk children and families, and your openness to research and the use of data, and not being afraid to look at that data and use it to improve the quality of care. Best wishes.
I will remember you.
Hi, Cyndi. We first met in Ohio 15 years or so ago. I was really impressed at the time with your leadership and the way you had started and really jump-started child protection mediation statewide in Ohio. Since coming to Florida, you've been one of the leading proponents for protecting children and also for empowering and strengthening and engaging families. You've made a real difference in Florida, and we're going to miss you terribly. I hope, though, when you leave, you and I will continue to collaborate on future projects, and I wish you and Fred all the success.
Will you remember me?
Hi, Cyndi. I wish I could be there to say goodbye in person, but unfortunately, this video will have to do. One of the things I'm often asked is how you succeed with the balanced scorecard, and there are a lot of answers, but probably the most important is an executive sponsor, someone who can really champion the idea and be a true ambassador. And when I think of that sort of leader, I think of you. From the very moment we met, and I remember our very first phone call thinking, wow, this is an impressive person, you really demonstrated your leadership with Balanced Scorecard and everything else you've done at Kids Central. So I know losing you is a tremendous blow to the organization, but with the foundation you've laid, you've got a tremendous group of leaders there, and that's, again, a testament to your leadership and your commitment to the organization. So best of luck in your new adventures in Phoenix, and I really hope our paths cross again soon. Thanks.
Good evening, Cyndi, Fred, and all my colleagues and good friends from Circuit 5. I'm sorry I couldn't be there in person tonight to say goodbye to such a wonderful lady, a true friend. If you know Cyndi, you know she's a force to be reckoned with, a force for good, a force for change, but most importantly, a force for children in care who often feel powerless. And believe me, because I know firsthand, you don't want to be on the other side of an argument with her. Even if you know you're right. But Cyndi, we can talk about additional insured at another time. Seriously, Cyndi, as a lawyer, as a former district administrator for the Department of Children and Families, as a leader at Kids Central, you've helped virtually thousands of children. The many innovative programs that Cyndi has initiated and implemented and the miraculous turnaround at Kids Central that she's engineered has made a positive difference in so many lives. Because of your wonderful work, Cyndi, many children who had no hope have been reunited with their families or have been adopted and now can dream about getting a good job or a college education and raising loving families of their own. You put your heart and your soul into this job, and you've lasted longer and accomplished more than many of your peers around the state. It's not easy being on the front lines of child welfare. It's a stressful job. But Cyndi has never lost sight of the humanity of those that she served and those that she's served with. If you walked into her office, you were as likely to be greeted by one of her beloved pugs as you were to be handed a slice of fresh baked pie. When you work in a profession where life literally hangs in the balance of every decision you make, it's nice to know you have a leader who gets it, who cares about you. Cyndi, I'm sure that your staff will miss you most, but I am also sure that they will carry on with the work that you've initiated. Speaking of innovations, when the concept of community-based care was first introduced, not everyone was a supporter. And quite frankly, at first, it didn't work quite as well as its designers had hoped. But that didn't stop Cyndi. She took the failing enterprise and she turned it around. She was able to do this not because she was a wonderful manager, which she is. She was able to turn around Kids Central because she made sure that the community was engaged and knew what was at stake. That's why we call it community-based care. It has to be community-based and it has to care. She understood from the beginning that for community-based care to work, you had to have programs like the successful neighborhood projects, where real people are helping their neighbors and friends take advantage of valuable and uplifting social services. Take, for instance, the Crystal Heights neighborhood projects in Crystal River, where the Meeks families was concerned about children being exposed to drugs and to theft and to violence. Mr. and Mrs. Meeks decided to do something. They started a weekly ball game, complete with hot dogs and sodas in their front yard so the children of the neighborhood could drop by and have something positive to do. Sometimes it was soccer, sometimes football, and if they were having fun, then they could stick around after the game. They could join in the Meeks Bible study group. The response from other parents in the neighborhood was overwhelming. It's a great story, and it's exactly the kind of thing that was envisioned when community-based care was created, using resources in innovative ways to give families the power to impact their neighborhoods. Once more, this neighborhood program and others like it work. The number of kids coming into care from that neighborhood are coming down. There are many stories like this, where Cyndi's personal involvement and commitment with families and neighborhoods and the entire communities were making a difference. And while Florida's loss is really Arizona's gain, I want to thank you, Cyndi, for creating and leaving such a powerful legacy, a legacy where vulnerable kids and their families are better off now than they have ever been before, because you created a culture that encouraged and rewarded creativity and caring and inclusiveness. Good luck to you and Fred as you begin this new chapter. I'm sure that whatever you do next, you will continue to make a positive difference for the families you encounter and the communities you serve. Have a great night tonight, and God bless.
Will you remember me?
Cyndi, this is Jerry Regeer, and I heard that you were retiring, leaving Kids Central, and I wanted so much to be a part of your farewell party. But I just couldn't reschedule things and do so, so I'm so sorry to miss it. But I wanted to send you this video to say what a joy it has been to know you and to have had the opportunity to work with you and be a colleague of yours. I remember so well the first time you came to DCF for your interview. And I was very impressed with you then, obviously. I hired you, and I still am today. You've really been a star in what you've done at Kids Central and what you did in your district at DCF. Your love and concern for kids, your care for your staff, your management style of empowering staff and managing for results, and your easy style of building relationships with staff and with client families, with the community, your board, and yes, even with your bosses. All have made you a real star and a success at what you do. I remember the day I first introduced you there in the district office in Lakeland to the staff. And of course, having just hired you, wasn't totally sure what to expect, but you have just proven to be a tremendous leader. You did a great job there. Or do you remember the time I came and you showed me the hurricane damage? We spent an entire day driving around, a very hot day, and that was quite something to see how things had been damaged and how your staff were responding. In each situation of your career in Florida, you've led with grace, with purpose, with compassion, and with integrity. Thank you for being a friend and a great leader. I think John Cooper is following you, is that correct? John, you have big shoes to fill and a big heart to replace, but I know you will. I saw a group of men in my hometown. I saw a group of men tearing a building down. And with a heave and a hoe and a mighty yell, they swung the beam and the side wall fell. I asked the foreman, are these men skilled? The kind you would hire if you wanted to build? He laughed. And he said, why, no, indeed. Common labor is all I need. Because we tear down in a day or two what it takes a builder 10 years to do. And I thought to myself as I walked away, which of these roles do I want to play? Am I a person that just tears down as I make my way foolishly around? Or am I compassionate, ready and skilled, a disciplined person trying to build? Cyndi, you have been a builder. You have left a legacy and built an incredible organization and outreach in the Ocala area and with Kids Central. And since the day I hired you, you've been that kind of person, and you have made a difference. And you can be very proud of your service. Thank you. I love and admire you, and God bless you. Wish I could be there with you. Bye-bye.
Hello, I'm David.
I'm Howard with the Bellamy Brothers.
And Cyndi, we want to commend you for your great work you've done with Kids Central up in Marion County. And congratulations on all your achievement. And good luck on your move to Arizona.
And wherever you go, let your love flow.
Love right shine all around us. So let's
as tears subside, I find it's all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say nothing shy away. Oh no, 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 not me, I did it.